KaiL Baxley, take one, rolling.
Can you talk more about your sound and how you came to develop that?
Yeah. Obviously a lot of gospel and a lot of roots that just kind of happens naturally. And then just being a product of my generation where you're influenced by so many different genres of things. I just kind of borrow from each one of those to make my own little sound.
It's like some guys like fancy cars, some guys like expensive clothes. KaiL would just want a choir.
Yeah,
he just wants
at
a
his
good
disposal.
Choir.
Get in, get come on, get that walk. Walk the lash.
I was working in a factory. I was probably 16 years old. I was working in a screen pattern factory. And I met this Haitian dude. We call him the Voodoo Man. His name's Berman. And around that same time, some friends got me to come out to, we just went to this random party out of this trailer park. And it was the first time I ever saw this guy, Dave, who's the local mechanic in our town where we grew up. And they were playing together. And I had never seen anything like it. I'd never seen anybody play their instrument that proficiently. I'd never seen, and they were writing their own songs, you know? They were a good bit older than me. And I was struck, you know? I had to learn, I had to know what they knew. And they were patient enough to teach me, you know? So between the two of them, I learned the basics of, and I still go home, and that's the first place I go. I go see them first, you know, when we still play music.
Hey, hey, motherfucker.
What's up? Come on in, come on in.
Oh, hey, how you doing?
Hey, buddy.
Come in.
I was far away. The truth is the truth, poor guys. Thank you. Excuse me for my accent, you know.
Yeah.
That's that expensive taste. That's that rich people beer.
Yeah. Well, Kale's fancy now. You know that, right?
Oh, yeah.
Fancy city boy.
He left his roots behind.
Tall boy, but
never leave your roots. You can't leave your roots.
Yeah, you can't leave your roots.
That's
how long has it been? Like 4 or 5 years?
Oh, well. Because, yeah, you know, my computer, my land, I'm start going down.
You've been going back to Haiti a good bit, yeah?
Oh, so much. Sometimes, yeah. I'm just follow you.
Yeah, yeah.
All I got to do, put spicy.
All you, do is, put that sexy spice on top.
It's spicy, that's my job. Yeah. Carolina.
South Cacalaca.
Like I taught you.
When you clap, I shook her.
Yeah, like.
Which one is your favorite?
He liked 3. I think 3 was... I can't ever tell until after, but it seems good to me.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3.
Think that'll work.
Yeah!
Yeah, I think so too!
Kind of grew up like American gypsies, you know? It was like trailer parks, project yards, beautiful old houses, cotton fields for miles.
Where's
that? I grew up in a little town called Williston, South Carolina. The only thing we have going on for us is that's where James Brown was born. Tiny little town. Like, I think there's probably like 4,000 people. When I was in high school, there's probably 6 or 7. It gradually keeps shrinking, you know? It's one of those places that the rest of the country kind of forgot about, you know? Still 100 years in the past. It definitely has a personality of its own. Probably a great place to come from and not a great place to be. I got out of there because you didn't have many choices. There's a lot of places in this country that are desperate, and I grew up in one of them. I love it. I love being from there. And I also spent my entire, you know, younger years trying to get out of there. So, you know.
And your godfather was...
Yeah, I got a stroke of good luck. I found myself in some trouble. I mean, I basically got stitched up by the cops, and I couldn't afford a lawyer. I feel like they thought I was a problem. They were probably gonna try to just nip in the bud before it got too bad, you know. Both of my parents were just criminals, you know, good-hearted criminals, but criminals nonetheless. And I kind of grew up in, you know, surrounded by all that. And to be fair, I was mixed up in a lot of dumb shit when I was a kid. And I had some old friends of my grandfather kind of show up, and he was the band director of the high school for 35 years, I think. And he basically was like, boy, you need to come live with us and let's get you back on track. And that's what they did. And that's where I got my first guitar. That's where music became like a real possibility for me. You know, I never had an instrument before that. And yeah, I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for them.
Okay, so tell me your name.
Richard Earl Lindell.
Okay. And
otherwise known as Chief.
So how did you first meet KaiL?
Well, he was just a little fellow, and I knew his grandfather real well. Grandfather lived up the street from us. He had a predicament where his mother was an addict, and so he struggled. You know, his aunt raised him. You know, lived with her until she couldn't do it, so then he was trying to live on his own. His daddy was out of the picture. He knew of him and had seen him once or twice, but that's about all. That his mother and father separated when he was early on, and. Anyway, his grandfather was raising him, and his grandfather died, and he left KaiL, you know, kind of destitute. And I told him one day, I said, well, how are you eating? And he said, I'm eating school lunches. And I said, well, what about your other meals? And he said, no, I just eat the school lunches. And I said, well, you go get your stuff and move in upstairs. He stayed with us, and we helped him through his senior year in high school.
Philosophy on life is probably ever-changing, you know, the self is ever-changing, but there's some basic fundamentals that I've had to put in place for myself just moving forward. Like, loss is gonna happen, you know, things are gonna happen for all of us. My mother lost a long battle with heroin 3 years ago now. I lost my father 6 years before that to the same. And it's a bit of a mind fuck. But you can't play the victim, man, you know? You play the victim in life and that's all you're gonna be. So you take what you've been given because you can handle it. And you can make yourself happy. Happy is a philosophy. So to go the full 360, I suppose my philosophy is find happiness.
I've not rehearsed this song, so
who knows what we're gonna get.
Hakuna Matata. Forget about everything was happening.